In this video, we will focus on calculating the age of the universe using the Lambda CDM model. Many people have probably heard some number for the age of the universe, but where does this number come from? How is this number calculated? The purpose of this video is to show how to obtain this result using calculus, a few approximations, and the latest data from the Planck satellite. This will hopefully demystify this number, and it is a good example of an application of the Lambda CDM model. Some of the math will maybe be a bit technical for many viewers, but the idea is to make the computation transparent so it's clear to all that there is no magic to this computation. If you have a very advanced calculator, it can also solve the problem much quicker for you. But that's enough talking for now. Let's get on with the video. To get started with this, we need to spend a little time explaining some terms. If you have seen some of my videos about cosmology, you will possibly have noticed this parameter a in the Friedmann equations. This is related to the scale factor, and as the name suggests, it is related to the expansion and contraction of space. With the help of a bit of general relativity, one can figure out that this parameter is related to the redshift z. This is a physical parameter indicating how much light has redshifted from traveling through space. And the relation to the scale factor is as follows. A is equal to A0 divided by 1 plus z, where A0 today is equal to 1. From this equation, we can see the relationship between the expansion and the redshift of light. Using the definition of the Hubble parameters in terms of the scale factor, h is equal to 1 over a times dA over dt, one can relate all of this with time, and this allows us to obtain an equation for calculating the age of some cosmic event. In its integral form, the equation for the present day age becomes t is equal to the integral from 0 to 1 over 1 plus z of the equation 1 over a h, and we are integrating with respect to a. And this we will need later. Before we can compute anything, we need to get more familiar with what this Hubble parameter is, such that we can do the integration. By considering the Friedmann equations, we can write the Hubble parameter in terms of the redshift as follows. H is equal to H0 and the square root of omega r, and in parentheses 1 plus z to the fourth plus omega m, and in parentheses 1 plus z to the third power plus omega k, and in parentheses 1 plus z squared, and then plus omega lambda, where h0 is the present day value of the Hubble parameter. We also see all the omega density terms with different factors of redshift z, and the different density terms are first the radiation density, omega r. This is the density of objects like photons that are lightweight and move at the speed of light or close to the speed of light. The next term is the matter density, omega m, which considers all the matter, both dark matter and usual visible baryonic matter. The next term is the curvature term, omega k, which takes into account the curvature of the universe. The last term is the dark energy term, omega lambda. In the Lambda CDM model, the curvature is flat, and this corresponds to omega k being equal to 0. Thus, this term can be removed. At this point, there are three density terms left, and one could compute the age using all three terms using numerical computations. But as one can show, also from looking at the CMB, the radiation term is insignificant in today's universe, so we can also set it to 0. Thus, we are left with the much simpler equation, where the Hubble parameter with respect to the redshift is equal to H0 and the square root of omega m, and in parentheses 1 plus z to the third power plus omega lambda. Thus, we are now left with a much simpler equation with only two terms. Since we want the Hubble parameter in terms of the scale factor, we can just use the relation presented earlier to obtain that the Hubble parameter in terms of the scale factor is equal to H0 and in the square root omega m times a to the minus third plus omega lambda. this equation we can integrate analytically, and we will get to that very soon. Now that we have figured out the Hubble parameter and obtained an equation to calculate the age of the universe, we simply need to put the two together and we obtain the following equation. T is equal to the integral from 0 to 1 over 1 plus z, and we are integrating over 1 over h naught, the square root of omega m times a to the power of minus 1 plus omega lambda times a squared. And we are again integrating with respect to a. Note that from the integral there is an additional factor of a, so that is why the powers are a bit different now. At this point the situation is in some sense straightforward, we just need to solve this integral. This can be done with a computer or by hand. It is not the easiest thing to do by hand, but you can do it using the following substitution, where you define that a is equal to the cubed root of omega m divided by omega lambda, and also in your cubed root you have hyperbolic sine squared of y. To make this work, one can pull out a factor of square root of a and then pull out a factor of omega m. I will skip showing this because it's just tedious and ugly algebra. If you want, you can do it by hand yourself and try it out. This substitution though might not seem like the most obvious choice, but using some clever algebra it works out as the very simple integral. T is equal to 2 over 3 times h naught times the square root of omega lambda. And then we just integrate with respect to y, which we can easily integrate using that the integral of nothing with respect to y is just equal to y. And then we can substitute in the definition of y, where y is equal to the arc hyperbolic sine of the square root of lambda l divided by lambda m times, still in the square root, a cubed. This leaves us with the final equation after substituting the correct limits into the integral. T is equal to 2 over 3 h naught square root of omega lambda times arc hyperbolic sine of the square root of omega l divided by omega m, and then in parentheses again we have 1 over 1 plus z cubed, which is the integration limit. And this is our final result. Now we have derived the equation for the age of the universe from scratch using some clever algebra substitution and calculus. Having carefully derived this equation, we just need to plug in the relevant values. To calculate the current age, we must set the redshift to z equal to 0, as this is the current redshift. This simplifies the equation a bit to T naught, which is now our age of the universe, is equal to 2 over 3 times h naught times the square root of omega lambda, and then we have again the arc hyperbolic sine of the square root of omega lambda divided by omega m, which is our result. The final thing we need to do is to pick the latest values of the matter and dark energy densities and the Hubble constant from the latest Planck data from 2018. Here we find that h naught is equal to 67.5 times kilometers per second times megaparsecs, and then we have that omega m is equal to 0.315, and thus omega lambda is equal to 0.685. If we plug in these numbers, we obtain the age of 13.78 billion years, and this is the widely accepted value. Finally, we can discuss the approximation of ignoring radiation. Since the radiation density today is around the order of 10 to the minus 4th, including it doesn't really change this result significantly, and this rather crude computation is actually rather accurate. A more refined value would give 13.772 billion years, but the uncertainty on this calculation is around 40 million years, so we indeed got within the uncertainty of this result ignoring radiation. Remember that this result we got now is considering the Lambda CDM model, which is considered to be the best current model. I hope this video made it clear that to figure out the age, one simply needs a bit of algebra and calculus. There is no magic to it. And hopefully you now also have an idea of how the result is calculated, even if you didn't catch all of the math. If you have any questions, please put them in the comment section together with any feedback. If you would like to support the channel, check out the link in the description. As always, I hope you liked the video. If you did, please like, subscribe, and share it with your friends. As always, stay tuned for the next video.